She is tarnishing the reputation of every Muslim, every American Muslim. And they know it now. Mm-hmm. And they, I mean, I speak to, I mean, to in the district, I speak to Somalis and I speak to Muslims. And they, the majority agreed that she tarnished their reputation. People there are not waiting just for handouts. These are hard workers. All that they want is to have better lives, to send their kids to better school, to have a safe district.
So what else are you going to do in Minnesota's 5th district to supplant Ilhan Omar?
Before that, I am planning and I will represent every voter in this district, and not even a voter, every resident of the 5th district, because I am running to represent them. I'm planning to introduce Minneapolis and the 5th district to DC, not bring DC to Minneapolis and to that district. She failed to do anything for them. And for me, this is, I mean, she's supposed to be a public servant. A public servant means that you serve your constituents. And that's what I'm planning to do. I will represent every resident of the 5th district, regardless of color, ethnicity, faith, and political affiliation.
What do you think the Somali community thinks of her?
So they are. Yeah. Seriously? They are sick and tired of her scandals, of her outside influences, of her narrative that she is tarnishing the reputation of every Muslim, every American Muslim. And they know it now. Mm-hmm. And they, I mean, I speak to, I mean, to in the district, I speak to Somalis and I speak to Muslims. And the majority agreed that she tarnished their reputation. People there are not waiting just for handouts. These are hard workers. All that they want is to have better lives, to send their kids to better school, to have a safe district.
You mean the same thing as every other American?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. We don't need names. We are all Americans. I don't, when I travel, when people ask me, oh, where are you from? I don't say I'm an American from, I am an American, period. And that's the values that I have are the American values. And the people I love are the Americans. Does it mean that I hate Iraq? It's always that's where I was born. And these are my extended families. But when it comes to my heart is here. That's why I've been living here for 30 years and I'm not planning to go anywhere. And that's why I have only one passport, which is the U.S. passport.
Will you come on stage with me? I have a show in Minneapolis for my book tour.
I would love to.
All right, I'm going to bring you on stage. We're going to do some stuff.
If you change your mind, I'll sue you.
Well, now it's been recorded. All right, okay. I'll get you the date, but I'll be in Minneapolis around the May 10th or so.
I would be honored to do so.
I would be honored to do so. Ilhan will not be happy with us. No. Nope. I'll invite her too, though. If she's watching right now, she's welcome to come on stage with both of us, and we'll see what happens.
I've been inviting you for.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, you can talk to the camera right there.
A cup of coffee forever. So I think maybe we should have coffee in the neighborhood that you don't live there anymore because you moved to D.C. So I'm in Minneapolis. Where is she? She's in D.C.
Yeah. Can you talk a little bit about some of the other scandals related to her? Because there's a lot of weird stuff out there, and for the last 2 years, it was only these very. I don't want to say very far right. It was seemingly far right outlets. I don't even want to say that. There were outlets on the right that are ignored by mainstream that were saying there was this weird thing with her and her brother and passports and this whole thing. Can you kind of get me up to speed on what we know?
I don't speak about it, but it's. There are investigations about. So many things, like three, four, for me, one is many.
Yeah.
And especially about the immigration fraud, because apparently based on a community leader in the Somali community came out and including pictures and let me tell you what happened. And then hopefully the investigation would lead to, because she would never talk about it. And it's like, oh, this is so appalling.
Yeah. Well, so she's under investigation right now.
Definitely.
For immigration fraud.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Apparently, she had a brother who lived in the United Kingdom, in London. And according to her close friends that went on the record saying that because her brother was gay, so she decided to bring him to the U.S., being inside within the Somali community, so maybe he'll get cured. This is the one
wow.
who defends the LGBT community.
Yet she wants to cure her brother.
By being in this community. So he came, but as a British citizen, he cannot live here. So basically, they got married, and to give him, well, it's not like for any other reasons. I mean, it's committing an immigration fraud,
mm-hmm.
and that's how he got his citizenship. She brought him to cure him. And basically, she used to say, according to her friends and to the people that went on the record, saying that he's been around the wrong crowd in England. So it's better for him to come here and be around us.
Right. Okay, so putting aside the part about the gay brother and the curing, which is bad enough in and of itself, especially by her own progressive ideals, where she's supposed to be for gay people, but that's not criminal in and of itself. Marrying your brother for the purposes of getting him
immigration
status is immigration fraud, and this is under investigation right now.
Yes.
Do you think it's bizarre the way the mainstream media seems to be covering this up, or is that just sort of congruent with everything else that
I think we got used to the mainstream media, sadly, but we got used to it. Have we ever heard anything about anybody, about progressive, about a Democrat? No. It's always about the us. The conservatives, the Republicans, it's always about us. What about all the scandals that were around a large percentage of the Democrats? It goes under the radar, and they would, even if they mention it, they would mention it in times that are not very popular, so and then that's it. And
right.
That's
well, instead the New York Times writes a piece about the new hip artist in town, Hunter Biden.
Yeah.
You saw that one in the Times?
He's
the new hot artist in town. I'm pretty sure Donald Trump Jr. wouldn't get the same coverage in the New York Times.
No, not even not Trump, not his kids, his children.
Does it feel in a weird way? So for someone that was a journalist under a dictatorship, does that, or came from a country that was a dictatorship, when you see the way our media behaves right now?
Similar. Exactly similar. I mean, having, they always try to defend all the mainstream media, they pretend to defend the First Amendment. But what they're doing is so anti the First Amendment. Freedom of speech is the most important thing. They are just doing, and I know it. I know what that narrative of the progressives and of Ilhan or of Rashida, what they bring. I've seen the consequences of the hatred. I've seen the consequences of oppression and of division. I ran away from it, and I was fighting it for 31 years. And I am, as an American citizen, would stand against it. I was standing against it, and I will until the day I die.
Yeah. Does anything about the machine that you're going up against scare you in any way? Just, I mean, at the most human level. I mean, I know you've been through worse in a lot of ways, but
I'll tell you.
But it's a huge machine.
And especially when it comes to radical Muslims and to the Muslim Brotherhood and to the people behind the Muslim Brotherhood, they've no. If you hear or if you read that I committed suicide, I'm not suicidal. I'm very happy, so look for them, because definitely I'm not. We've seen suicides here and there lately, and the Muslim Brotherhood is a terrorist group, and the first thing would be my priority when I get elected in November, that I will make sure the Muslim Brotherhood would be designated as a terrorist group, such as several countries, Egypt, that's where the Muslim Brotherhood was formed.
Yeah.
Egypt consider it, and other countries in the region consider it a terrorist group, and we should. We should I'm not scaring, I'm not trying to scare people, but we shouldn't be afraid of name or calling things with their real names. And that's not Islamophobe, that's not anti-anything. That's being anti-terrorism and anti-radicalism. And if I don't stand against it, who else?
If you're looking for more honest and thoughtful conversations about politics instead of nonstop yelling, check out our politics playlist. And if you want to watch full interviews on a variety of topics, watch our full episode playlist all right over here. And to get notified of all future videos, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell.